Hey guys, here's Rory, here's the LARP guy. I just wanted to show you today a quick little chainmail tutorial on how to build a European 4-in-1. Now this is one of the most universal weaves. It can be used in a lot of different things like armor, bracelets, a couple of my new favorite projects, chainmail ball, and of course, chainmail pouches. So this is just one of the most simplest weaves to do, and quite handy in doing lots of different things. So sit back and let's get started. Okay guys, so let's get started making our 4-in-1 European chainmail. So what the rings we're going to be using here right now, these are 5/16 inner diameter 16 gauge anodized aluminum rings, and these are 5/16 inch inner diameter 16 gauge solid EPDM rubber rings. Now all these rings you can find at theringlord.com, or you can easily make some of your own metal rings if you wanted to. This just saves me a little time and I get a lot more colors this way. So whenever you make your rings or you buy them, they will come just like this, slightly split just apart. So what we need is we need to open them up. Now I've got two different sets of pliers here. When you're using softer metals like aluminum, you want to try and use nylon jawed pliers. That way you don't mar the rings up or anything like that. But sometimes I can't get into a weave, or I'm using steel rings and such, so I like to use these two pliers right here. So those both just jeweler pliers. These are smooth jawed needle nose pliers, and then smooth jawed curved pliers. I don't remember the actual name for these. So what we're going to use is we're going to use the nylon jaw pliers, since we don't want to mar anything up. And now we need to open these rings up and make them look like this. And let them be split open that far so we can loop them in and out. So the way you want to do that is you want to take the ring, grab it by both sides here, and twist. You see, you don't want to take the ring, you don't want to pull, because if you pull the ring, you'll actually end up deforming the ring and it won't be a perfect circle anymore. So instead of grabbing here and then pulling outward to split the ring open like this, you want to twist the ring and split it open like that. So your ring will be marred like that, twist it open, not pull it apart. So just twist the rings open. Open. This will also be the same way you'd close it. So you could twist it open, loop in your rings, and then you'll twist it closed. And the ones I'm using right now, these are saw cut, so they have a very nice flush finish. But, and normally, if you were doing an all-metal shirt or all-metal bracelets, you would have closed ring as well. So you'd have a pile of open rings, and then you would twist close and make a pile of closed rings. But since we're substituting in the rubber rings here that are already solid and closed, we don't have to do that, which will save us some time. Okay, so to start out, we're going to take one open ring and put four closed rings into it. And we're going to go ahead and twist that closed. That's exactly why this is called 4-in-1, because there are four rings inside of one ring. So there you go. And you want to make sure your rings lay so they're slightly overlapping. So you've got your outside rings be overlapping. They're currently going, the outside rings lay like this, and the inside rings will lay like this. So let's go ahead and add one more set of rings. We're going to do some speed weaving here real quick. So I'm going to stage a couple rings to extend it and make it longer. We're just going to be using one open ring and two closed rings. So I'm just going to go ahead and stage those up right here. Okay. So now one open ring, two closed rings. Now with the way this is currently laying, I'm going to go underneath one of the black rings, just one, and then I'm going to go over top and go down through one black rubber ring. That way I'm adding two rings to my open ring with two rings also. So once again, there's only four rings. And then straighten out, and see the pattern continues. And do the same thing again. Under one, over to the next. And then twist closed. One, over to the next. Twist close. All right, and there you have it. Linked up, it's about five links wide now. So we've got five center rings, and we actually have six outside rings because we started with four on the main one. And that just gives you, so whenever you go to do your closure later, this has already got extra rings on it. All right, now instead of lengthening it, let's expand it and make it wider. So if you want to do a wide bracelet or do a shirt, you would eventually need to extend it downward. So, shirt off. We need one open ring and two closed rings. And then we're going to start on one side. We're going to grab two closed rings here. So these two end overlapping rings right there. We're going to take this ring and go into both of them. We need to make sure we keep our pattern going the right direction, so we go slide it underneath, go up through one, and then also go up through the other. That way that'll keep the pattern going the right direction. Let's put that down so we don't scratch anything. Twist it closed. Go ahead and lay this out so y'all can see it again. Once you get going fast enough and you know how your weave is going, you can just let it bunch up and you can keep track of it still. Alright, so now got that started. Let's go ahead and stage some more rings. Okay. So now when we want to extend it, we're going to add one more open ring and only one more closed ring, because there's already three rings here that we're going to be going through. So, one open ring, one closed ring. You can do the same as we did before, go underneath one ring, underneath another, then we're going to go over and down through one ring. Okay. Go ahead and lay this out so you can get another look at it. Sometimes the end rings here want to loop over each other, so just gotta make sure to lay those back out. And if you just kind of tap it, the rings will actually fall into their natural order of how they want to sit. It gives you a nice look of how dense the weave will be. So now add one more. So under one, under two, over to the third. Close the ring. Right. Under one, under two, up and over to a third. Close that off. Okay, and then add on the last one, under one, under two, up and over to a third. Okay, make sure those all lay the right way. Tap it a few times and let it settle. So there you go. So extended it down one extra row. So we've got five rings wide and about, I like to count mine by whichever one is the closure ring, so two rows deep. Now, last thing I want to show you is how to connect two pieces of chain. So now if you wanted to do, you know, a continuous bracelet that looped all the way over, or if you were connecting the seams of a shirt, so you would do it. So first you gotta make sure your rings are all going the same direction. Tap a few times, let it lay flat. So make sure, so here we have our metal rings in the center overlapping in this direction. And then this is matched up, each ring is overlapping in that direction, while our black rubber is overlapping this direction. Now, to connect this, you don't need any more closed rings. You just need two open rings. Or, well, depending on how many rows you have, that's how many open rings you need. So, I'm going to go ahead and take my pliers here, because it'll be a little easier for me to control and for you to see. So, what I'm going to do is I'm going to go down into this part of the chain. So I want this metal ring to go underneath this metal ring. And I want to loop it through two black rings. So I go down and over and up. And I'm going to take this one and lay it on top of this one. So I'm going to go up through this one ring and then over. Then go ahead, grab this and close it. Okay. Lay it out one more time for you to see. Okay. So, there's the ring we just connected. Now we're going to add this last ring right into here, doing the same thing. Except I'm going to come in the opposite direction this time, so I'm going to go on top of this ring here, and then come below this ring here. So go down. Sorry, it's going to be a bit of a jumble, and then back up. Grab hold of it, and then twist it closed. All right. There you have it. You just connected your European foreign one, and then see, you could take a full chain like this and then loop it over and then have your same sides here, connect them up like that, and then that would give you a full bracelet. All right. One more presentation. Ta-da! All right, guys. So there you go. Simple 4-in-1 European chainmail pattern, which can be used in a lot of different projects, as I showed you before. Chainmail balls, pouches, bracelets, armor, belts even, continue on from there. And it's really the best way to get started, and later will lead into 6-in-1 and 8-in-1 and King's Mail. And it's really just the best place to get started, quite universal. So thanks for watching, guys. Feel free to do whatever it is with the buttons down there, like, share, subscribe, whatever else anyone else keeps saying. And check back for more tutorials coming soon. Thanks, guys.